Advocate this morning. These men, our brothers, brought forward by their families, their communities, come today to offer themselves to the Lord and to the Church's service. We are indeed grateful for God's grace, the Spirit's action in our lives. And I'll pray in this Mass, the Lord might be merciful to them and to us. And we ask that He allow us to share the ministry of His Son Jesus. Brothers and sisters, let us take all of our sins and so prepare to celebrate the sacred mysteries.
To see them be served by
of deacon, maybe of active in action, gentle in ministry, and constant in prayer. To our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Greatly. Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Juan, Moreno. James, Ogbonna. Diaz, Purificacion.
Thank you.
relying on the help of the Lord God and our Savior, Jesus Christ, we choose these, our brothers, for the order of the Catholic.
You are not only hearers of this gospel, but also
ministers. Holding the mystery of faith with a clear conscience, express by your actions the word of God which your lips proclaim, so that the Christian people, brought to life by the Spirit, may be a pure offering accepted by God. Then, on the last day, when you go out to meet the Lord, you will be able to hear him say, "Well done, good and faithful servant. Enter into the joy of your Lord."
We elect and we stand.
Before you enter the order of the diaconate, you must declare before the people your intention to undertake this office. You resolve to be consecrated for the church's ministry by the laying on of my hands and the gift of the Holy Spirit. You resolve to discharge the office of deacon with humble charity, in order to assist the priestly order and to benefit the Christian people. You resolve to hold fast to the mystery of faith with a clear conscience, as the apostle urges, and to proclaim this faith in word and deed according to the gospel and the church's tradition.
Do you promise respect and obedience in me and my successor?
I do.
May God look you down to the work in you. You promise respect and obedience. obedience to me and my successors. May God, who has begun a good work in you, bring it to fulfillment. My dear people, let us pray that God, the all-powerful Father, will mercifully pour out the grace of his blessing on these, his servants, whom in his kindness he raises to the order of the diaconate.
Let us see.
Amen.
Lord God, mercifully hear our prayers, and graciously accompany with your help what we undertake by virtue of our office. Sanctify by your blessing these men we present, for in our judgment we believe them worthy to exercise sacred ministries. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Temple, and as once we chose the sons of Levi to minister in the former tabernacle, so now you establish three ranks of ministers in their sacred offices to serve in your name. And so, in the first days of your church, through the inspiration of the Holy Spirit, your sons, apostles, appointed seven men of good repute to assist them in the daily ministry, that they might devote themselves more fully to prayer and preaching of the word. By prayer and the laying on of hands, they entrusted to those chosen men the ministry of serving at table. We beseech you, Lord, look with favor on these servants of yours who will minister at your holy altar and who we now come to dedicate to the office of deacon. Send forth upon them, Lord, we pray, for the Holy Spirit, that they may be strengthened by the gift of your sevenfold grace for the faithful carrying out of the work of the ministry. May there abound in them every gospel virtue, unfailing love, concern for the sick and poor, unassuming authority, the purity of innocence, and the observance of spiritual discipline. May your commandments shine forth in their conduct, so that by the example of their way of life, they may inspire the imitation of your holy people. In offering the witness of a clear conscience, may they remain strong and steadfast in Christ, so that by imitating on earth your Son, who came not to be served but to serve, they may be found worthy to reign in heaven with him, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen.
Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read. Teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach. Receive the gospel of Christ, whose herald you have become. Believe what you read, teach what you believe, and practice what you teach.
the Almighty God.
Make the Lord of the sacrifice of your hands, for the grace of the Lord is his name, for our good and for the whole of the Church.
Holy Father, whose Son chose to wash the disciples' feet and still set us an example, accept, we pray, the oblation of our service, and grant that, offering ourselves as a spiritual sacrifice, we may be filled with the spirit of humility and zeal through Christ our Lord.
For the redemption of their souls,
Remember also, Lord, your servants who have gone
us also your servants, all sinners, open your abundant mercies, graciously grant us some share in fellowship with the holy apostles and martyrs, with John the Baptist, Stephen, Matthias, Barnabas, and all your saints, admit us, we beseech you, into their company, not only our merits, but grant us your pardon, through Christ our Lord.
Through whom you continue to remain all of these mercies, O Lord, you sanctify them, fill them with life, bless them, and bestow them upon us. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours, forever and ever.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
As we approach the table of the Lord and his ordination mass, for those in the balcony, please remain in the
Woo!